Hey guys, buongiorno, Nico here, and welcome to wearepalermo.com. In this video, I intend to explain all of the things you should do when visiting Palermo. There are many items that should make this list, and I'm quite proud to say that, so mind you, but I decided to narrow it down to the top 5 important things. I call this the 5 anti know-it-all. Everyone knows someone in their life that they deem Mr. Know-it-all, who tries to make you feel like an idiot, right? Someone that says things like, "What? You haven't been there? You go all the way to Italy and you don't even bother to do that?" I hate those people. So let's avoid them by telling you the 5 things you should be doing when you visit Palermo. So, number 1, a nice trip among the monuments. Now, I'm not going to push up my glasses and claim to be a snooty history professor, but I can give you 3 reasons why you should certainly be doing this. First point is that Palermo is the most conquered city in history. We have been under the rule of Greeks, Romans, Spaniards, Arabs, Phoenicians, and more. And each of these has left a cultural mark on Sicily. Secondly, Palermo has the second largest historical center in all of Europe. Someone might say it's the largest, others say it's the 3rd largest, doesn't matter. Just know that 15 cultures have passed through and each left dozens of influential markers on Sicily. Last, we have nearly a dozen of UNESCO World Heritage Sites and another dozen soon to make this list. If you don't know this organization, Google it. To make a concise point here, there is an endless supply of sites and artifacts of historical significance throughout the city. Believe me, you will not regret checking them out. And don't forget, Mr. Know-it-all is waiting for you to come back. Number 2, take a dip in the crystal seas. There is a clear reason why foreign tourists overrun the island year after year, and it is mainly because they spend all the year in the shade and they need our sun and sand. We have tons of sandy and rocky beaches complete with water that is so clear that it looks like mineral water. I don't think that any country could argue or get offended at the statement that our beaches are the most beautiful in all of Europe. Number 3, binge on some excellent cuisine and street food. I intend to go over this topic at great length on a separate video, so allow me just to hit a few key points here. Point A, Palermo is deemed the street food capital in all of Europe. B, fish and vegetables are the most prevalent components to Sicilian diets. Point C, the true Sicilian pizza can have some peculiarities such as the use of local ancient grains in the crusts. And point D, Sicily is among the foremost locations in the world for sweets and ice cream. And to put a specific point on this, Sicily was the birthplace of ice cream. No worries, I'm gonna go over this in another video. Number 4, enjoy the nightlife and the aperitif options. When you come to Palermo, you can expect to encounter a very active nightlife scene. If I have to describe this in one sentence, I would say it is drink and eat outside in ancient alleyways of historical sites or along the sea. A typical Friday or Saturday night divides into 3 phases. Begins with the Italian-style aperitif after sundown. This is usually a local wine or Aperol spritz in the old streets of the old town district. You will feel like you are part of one of those martini commercials, believe me. Then proceed with so many Sicilians on the alcoholic pilgrimage that follows, moving from one bar to the next in old town. And rounding off the evening, go to the centuries-old marketplace in Vuciria to enjoy a bit of a no-rules feel for the rest of your night. You can sometimes be here until the sun comes up. If you can still make it to your feet, go to a club or maybe more wisely, head to your accommodations for the night. The next morning, you get another island tradition, the Sicilian hangover. Number five, take some tours and trips of neighboring villages. Sicily is full of unique, distinct, and picturesque villages. What do you do in these villages? You generally do five things. You walk around with your camera and a permanent smile. You visit major monuments and pretend to know the significance. You take thousands of photos of the dramatic landscapes, monuments, and more. And you do this not for the memories, as you know, but just to make your followers on social media jealous. You binge on the local food and lie to yourself that you can worry about your diet when you get back home. Then you return to Palermo satisfied. That's what you needed to know. If you want to visit Palermo and return to your friends saying, "I visited Palermo like a real Sicilian and not just like a tourist," then you can have a look at our extensive guide, The Sicilian Way. It's the most complete, regularly updated, and authentic guide available for your travel plans. Take a look at it. This is it. See you in the next video. Ciao.